Welcome back to the Mountain Morning Show. We love to talk about art here on the program, which is why I'm very happy to have Debra Groesser here with the American Impressionist Society. She's the president. Welcome.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
I had a little conversation with my co-host a little while ago about Impressionism, and she was sort of in under the impression that Impressionism was dying a little bit. But that's not true.
Not at all.
By any stretch of the imagination.
Not by any stretch of the imagination.
If anything, it might be growing.
Absolutely. Absolutely. We've seen our organization over the last 5 years grow from about 1,000 members to 1,500 members.
Wow.
From all over the country.
That's saying something.
It is. And, you know, there's kind of a resurgence of plein air painting as well. It's gotten to be very, very popular. And plein air is inherently impressionistic, because it's all about painting the effects of light.
But that's on location. That's the difference. Is that it?
Right.
Pretty much?
Plein air is done on location. And there's a lot of our artists that don't do plein air, but they're still impressionists. They do their work in the studio.
I see. So, mm-hmm. Usually from a photo or something, or from their memory sometimes.
Photo, memory, sometimes from plein air studies that they've out and done. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yep. That's an interesting idea. Or a drawing, I suppose, is another way that they might do that.
Sure.
That's fascinating. I had never thought of that. it seems that maybe Impressionism has sort of a little more of an opening too for people. It seems a little more inviting to artists. Is that right?
That's what we're hearing. You know, there are some artists that paint very tightly rendered things. Very, you know.
Almost
very
photo
strong.
Quality.
Almost
level,
photorealistic, yeah. And some are very dark. The Impressionist paintings, though, tend to be you know, full of light and color and beautiful brushwork. And people just seem to really relate to that, you know, both artists and buyers.
And that can collectors. Be in watercolors, oils,
yes,
the
we,
variety.
Yes. In fact, our show, we have almost 200 paintings, and we have about 10 pastels and about 10 watercolors.
Wow.
as well as the oils. We've been really working on encouraging pastelists and watercolorists to submit work.
And watercolor certainly has been growing, there's no doubt.
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely.
Now, this is at the Montgomery-Lee Gallery is where you'll be
right.
showcasing these 200 pieces.
Right.
Talk a little bit about that. That is obviously a much bigger location than I realized it has enough for 200 pieces. Wow.
It is. And the gallery has done just a phenomenal job of hanging the work. They have two levels. So you walk in the front door, there's a level downstairs, and there's a lot of pieces down there, and then there's several areas on the upstairs level.
Wow.
That they have work too. So yeah, they were able to hang 200 pieces, and they've grouped them all by subject matter, and so it's just they've done an incredibly beautiful job.
That's amazing. Mm-hmm. Now, the opening is the 28th, is that right?
Tomorrow night,
yeah.
Tomorrow night, the 28th, from 5 to 9, there's a public opening reception, so everybody is welcome to come. About 7 o'clock, we'll do an awards presentation, and we have a lot of sponsors who've donated awards for the artists.
Oh,
we
that's
have
great.
One of our master artists, Albert Handel, will be here, and he's the judge. He's been teaching a workshop this week.
Is that right?
And then he'll judge the work, and then we'll give out the awards. We have a little, I think we're right at $70,000 in cash and merchandise.
Really?
Awards. Yes.
Wow.
Yes. $70,000. Our best of show award is $12,000 cash.
That is impressive.
Yeah.
This society is very large. I didn't realize how big it really is. Your membership, you said, again?
About 1,500 members from all over the country and, all over the United States. And a lot of them are actually going to be here tomorrow night. I've gotten messages from several of them that they're flying in or they just got in. And so, you know, folks can have a chance to come and meet the artists and talk
with
them.
So many of, you'd say, even maybe a majority of the people who are hung will be seen. Is that right?
I think we're probably about 75 out of the 200 artists will be here. So that's
great.
That's pretty phenomenal.
Yeah, it is. It's not often you can get that, but I think
that's
maybe
right.
Park City a good place to entice people to come.
It is. We move our show around every year,
right. So
to a different location. We try to cover the whole United States, you know, eventually. And so last year we were in Seattle. We've been in California. We've been in Denver. Denver, Scottsdale, Charleston, South Carolina.
Well, we're very lucky to have it here. That's awesome.
We're thrilled that Montgomery-Lee agreed to host our show.
It's so exciting to celebrate new artists and mm-hmm. old alike, and there are a mixture here. You've got some new young blood too, right?
Absolutely. We have one artist, Kyle Ma, who just turned 17.
Really?
And yeah, and I was shocked when I found out how old he was, but just a phenomenal painting. We've got a lot of younger folks coming up, and then we have some more seasoned ones like myself.
Right. You've been painting a while.
So I've been painting a while, yeah.
That's awesome. Well, let's talk about some of the artists. Who are some of your favorites? Who should we be like, oh, we've got to see this piece?
Oh, gosh. Oh,
that put you on the spot a little bit.
That's
but.
Pretty impossible.
Who are your favorites?
There's such a variety. There's several in this show that my husband and I personally have in our collection.
Okay.
Richard Oversmith is incredible. James Richards is, he has won one of the top awards, I think, for the last three or four years in a row.
Wow.
Yeah, Best of Show a couple of years ago. And John Cook is another one who's won Best of Show.
People should know him.
So, yeah. There are just so many. And the neat thing about Impressionism is that there's a wide range of style within the impressionistic genre of art. So some are a little bit tighter, some are a little looser, some have really thick brushwork, some not as thick of brushwork. So it's just an exciting show. And we've had, a lot of our members have said that's what they find exciting about our show is the variety, and not everything looks the same, you know?
I'm sure, though, that there is a lot of tie into the masterworks, certainly, mm-hmm. of Impressionism. When you look at what you're hanging right now, mm-hmm. these 200 pieces, can you relate to somebody? We usually look at this and go, wow, there's definitely some, you know, of a particular artist, some mm-hmm. inspiration. Can you talk about some of those?
Yeah, you'll see within Impressionism, we have some pastel pieces that might remind you of Degas. And, there's some that are, the classic broken brushwork, like Monet and Sisley and Pissarro and that. So you'll see a lot of, of course, it all started with the French Impressionists. And then we had American artists that went over and studied with them and brought that style back to America. And with
the world being so much bigger and with art being such a big part of it, it's still, we certainly hope always, mm-hmm. do you see in our future people who will be considered masterwork level?
Oh, definitely. We actually, we have 22 masters in our organization. We have three different membership levels, associate, signature, and master. And to achieve signature membership, you have to have been accepted into three of our national exhibitions.
Really?
And then we have our master artists who are invited, and they are examples of the highest level of quality of Impressionism. And
hanging galleries all over the world.
Mm-hmm. And you'll see 13 of our masters have works in this show. So
that's awesome.
Albert Handel, who I mentioned, is our judge of awards this year. He has a beautiful large piece in there. Kevin McPherson, who is from Taos. He actually won our very first Best of Show award in our very first exhibition.
How many years ago was
and,
that?
This is our 18th annual.
Wow.
18th annual
back
exhibition.
Back in 99.
Yeah.
That's exciting.
Back in 99. So, and he has an incredible portrait. He's been traveling a lot to China and doing a lot of work with children over in China and also down in Guatemala. And
that's neat.
So, taking and spreading it around the world, it's pretty exciting.
Mm-hmm. Art speaks to everyone, and that's, I think, the thing we need to remember.
Absolutely. It's a universal language. It really is a universal language.
Are you worried at all when you see that schools are cutting back on the arts? Is that something that for you guys is something that we should all be pushing back against?
Personally, I believe so, and I know the majority of our artists, if not all of them, believe that too. Art just enriches children so much, you know, it's been proven that children who are exposed to art and music and, you know, the humanities do better in school. I had an example of that myself when I was teaching a few years ago of a young man who was failing in school. And he was an incredible artist. And one day his mother came in and I just complimented him, and she was just shocked because he didn't concentrate at school at all and was failing classes. And today I saw him a couple of years ago at an opening of a credit union back in Omaha, where we live. And he was there, and he is now an architect. And
oh my.
Yeah, and he won an award for the design of this building. And he came up to me that day and he said, "You taught me, because of art, you taught me it was okay to be creative and it was okay to be different." And he said, "I would never be doing this without that."
That is touching.
And so, yeah, I was in tears.
Right.
We all were. But, you know, that's just one little example of how important art is to people. You know, creative people have a different learning style and all of that than a lot of people.
Not everyone learns. They tend to be very hands-on.
Right, very visual learners and that. So, yeah. So, I'd love to tell that story. I just think, you know, art is just so important. And we're actually talking about starting some youth programs within our organization. So, that's just in a little... just in the infant stage of discussions.
We like to hear that, because we know in Washington they're doing nothing to help this. In fact, if anything, they're really they're cutting the budgets for art programs throughout the country.
Yeah,
which is so awful.
It's difficult. So, you know, we hope that, you know, by people seeing us and seeing our show, and you know, that they're encouraged to try painting. You know, a lot of our members do teach and that too. So, you know, hopefully it'll inspire everybody.
There's a little, you know what, I think most people don't realize there's a painter in you at some level.
Absolutely.
Whether you want to embrace it or not, or whether you want to believe that you're decent or good or whatever the case is, there's something there.
Absolutely.
And your message, yourself can be expressed that way.
Absolutely.
If you're willing to try.
Absolutely. And you don't have to do it for a living.
Right.
You know, you don't have to make it a job
or
that, you know, just do it for the love of it. And one of my favorite quotes is Picasso said, every artist or every child is an artist, and the challenge is to remain an artist when you grow up.
I couldn't agree more.
Isn't that great? I love
that. Wow. You know,
I love that quote.
I have to remind myself, too, that photography and video are art.
Absolutely.
And we should be proud of those.
Absolutely.
But at the same time, I do recall, you know, going and trying my hand a little bit of painting, and I recognize now that very much, I'm definitely an impressionist if there's anything I can do.
There you go.
It's certainly impressionism. But, you know, the truth is that even if I wasn't particularly excited about what I was able to do in college with a professor that said, "Yeah, you're not an artist." But the truth was, hey, I've got a piece hanging up in a place downtown right now. So
there you go.
There's something.
Absolutely.
Right, for everyone.
Absolutely.
I just want to remind you that regardless of what you might think, regardless of what others might tell you, there's something inside that you should take a brush to.
Absolutely. I was told once by someone I cared about very much that I was no good and I would never do anything with my art. And, you know.
And now here you are.
And now
you're the president of the society.
25 years later, I never thought in a million years, but, you know.
Wow.
But everybody's got that creative side of them.
And,
just
need to touch it.
You do. You really do. And I would just encourage everybody to try it. You know, come and see shows like, you know, like
here you've
like
got a worldwide level show right
absolutely.
Here in Park City. It
absolutely.
Runs through October
29th.
So basically 30 days to check out some amazing art, 200 pieces.
Right.
I'd encourage you to go more than once.
Definitely. In fact, the gallery will be open on Friday night too for Art Stroll. And
perfect.
And a lot of the artists will be there. So I hope everybody will come and say hi.
Thank you so very much for being here and for what you're doing for art as you keep to representing it and helping people, you know, organize and make sure that it isn't a dying art.
That's exactly right.
Impressionism is alive and well, and you can be part of that too by certainly visiting the gallery, inspiring yourself to take brush to canvas. And we've got a lot more coming up as we wrap up this hour and this day here on the Mountain Morning Show, so don't go anywhere.